Here's your chance to build a stairway to, well, not heaven, but at least to a gold cup. A virtual gold cup. This exercise gets you familiar with how most of 3JS's geometric objects work. You'll be spending your time working inside the create stairs function. We're going to use the cube geometry method to create two pieces for steps, a vertical piece and a horizontal plank. Cube geometry is not a perfect name, since a cube is defined as having all its dimensions be the same size. Box geometry would have been better, but no big deal. Here's the code for defining the geometry for our two steps. The way cube geometry works is that you provide it a size in x, y, and z. It then creates a set of triangles for you, forming a box with these dimensions. Once you have this geometric object, you can use it as many times as you wish to create 3JS meshes, each of which consists of geometry and a material. You can use the position parameter on the mesh class to reposition the box, and in fact, you'll need to do this for the exercise. When you create a box, it is centered around the origin. For our vertical part of the step, we want this piece to be resting on the ground. To do so, we take half of the height of the piece and move it this distance upward, so that the bottom is now at ground level. The horizontal piece making up the flat part of the step is created with this code. In this case, we first push the step up half its thickness so it rests on the plane, then push it up the rest of the height of the vertical piece so that it rests on top. The Z position is also changed, pushing the plank so that one edge is at the origin, and then it pulls back a bit so that it rests firmly on the vertical piece. That's shown here. Got all that? Once you run the program, you'll see the two step pieces, with the vertical piece resting on the ground plane. You'll also notice a cool program feature. There are some controls available. The grids can help you get a sense of distance along each axis. They have lines every 100 units. Each is labeled with the axes that are in that grid plane. For example, since the y-axis is up for this scene, the XZ grid is on the ground plane. Your goal is to build a number of steps, one on top of the other going forward, that just reaches the gold cup. Here's what things will look like when you're done. Don't build any more steps than are necessary, or we'll charge you for extra time and materials. Plus, you won't pass the problem. I recommend that you first play around with the position parameter and see its effect on the model. Setting the position to zero shows what the block looks like centered at the origin. You should also consider using a loop, as it's a lot easier in the long run than brute force. Being a smart programmer can save you a lot of grunt work. Using programs to generate geometry such as a number of stairs is called procedural modeling. Personally, I'm pretty bad at using modelers, so I like modeling this way. It's great that with a few lines of code you can generate pretty complex models. Here's a procedural model called Sphereflake that I made more than 25 years ago. Around the same time, Pixar created a short film called Red's Dream, primarily using procedural modeling, since there simply weren't great modeling tools easily available back then. See the additional course materials to download the program for this model and others, along with pointers to many other related resources. But don't get distracted right now. Go ahead and build the steps.